This is TNT, bringing you the thrill of NASCAR, the drama of the PGA Grand Slam, and the excitement of the NBA. This is TNT.
Charlotte, the 2006 NASCAR Busch Series champion.
TNT Sports, in association with NASCAR, presents the Ford 300. The final race of the 2006 season for the NASCAR Busch Series. We're at the Homestead Miami Speedway in South Florida. A cool, clear night. The fans filing in. The teams lined up along pit road. Let's join them. Here's Alan Bestwick.
With Kevin Harvick, who at the end of the night tonight will receive the NASCAR Busch Series Championship Trophy after his incredible season. He also starts on the pole. How good is this car? Can you win?
Well, I think so. I mean, this U.S. Coast Guard Chevrolet has been really good all year, obviously, but you know, it was good in practice. We didn't practice much in the first one. Wanted to make sure we concentrated on cup qualifying. And the second practice was pretty good. So we'll hopefully we've made the right adjustments to keep up with the racetrack. And if not, we'll make the right adjustments early in the race and hopefully have a good night.
Kevin Harvick starts from pole, seeking a record-tying 10th win in the season. Here's Dave Burns.
And Matt Kenseth has two wins on the 2006 season in the Busch Series, the last one coming just last week at Phoenix. So, Matt, can you make it two in a row tonight?
I'll find out in a while. I think we got a really good car. I don't know. The 21's pretty stout every week. And, Carl, as he likes to remind us, he's the best driver out there, so he'll be tough to beat. But I don't know. I think we got a good car. That was a really good lap qualifying, I think, for the time of day that we went. So Jimmy's done a great job on these things, and Chip and all these guys that work on it. So hopefully we'll be up there and have a shot at it.
Matt Kenseth will start fifth today in the 17 car. To Marty Snyder.
Well, Dave, it's been about 4 months since Carl Edwards, the self-proclaimed best driver out there, has been to victory lane. Your teammates taking a shot at you. What do you think about that?
That's all right. Matt was, see, the problem is Matt was saying, after he ran a good lap in qualifying, there was a rumor around that Matt was saying that he was going to win the race and all that. So I mentioned it on TV, and he was upset about it. But he is an amazing driver. I look forward to hopefully fighting for a win with Matt tonight.
And it's been a while since you've been to victory lane. Real quick, can you change that tonight?
Well, heck yes, we can change it. That's what we're here to do. So hopefully we'll put a Ford up there in victory lane.
Carl Edwards starts third tonight. Matt Yoakam.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. pulling double duty this weekend. So is tonight all about fun or all about learning for tomorrow's big race?
Actually, it's been about learning. Tony Jr.'s been working on this car a little bit. We've had a lot of help from Clinton Cram and a bunch of guys at DEI. But Tony Jr. and myself, we've learned a lot by being able to use this car and practice this car and race this car tonight. So it's been a huge help, and when we got here with the cup car, we were terrible, and it's this car's really helped us get that thing working pretty good.
Two wins this season, looking for a third. He's never won here at Homestead. In fact, his best finish is second. He rolls off from the 16th position. Bill?
Thanks, Matt. 43 cars lined up along pit road. A lot of different stories about to unfold tonight in the season finale for the NASCAR Busch Series. Let's take you trackside now and join tonight's pre-race ceremonies.
Race fans, are you ready? Joining us on the pre-race stage tonight are service men and women from Southcom here in Miami. Now please rise and remove your hats and direct your attention back to the stage. Presenting our national colors is the United States Coast Guard Honor Guard. And now for today's invocation, please welcome Pastor Pedro Garcia of Calgary Chapel in Kendall.
All right, let's pray. And Father, we thank you so much for bringing us here this day for this final race of the Busch Series here at the Homestead Miami Speedway. Father, we do pray, Lord, for your protection over every driver. We thank you for the talent you've given to them. We pray for each of the crew members, owners, sponsors. Lord, we pray for their families, their kids, that are here today. We pray that you would bless them. And Father, we thank you for these, the greatest fans in all of sports. God, we pray for just a wonderful night here, enjoying this beautiful weather as we watch this race. And we thank you for your son, Jesus Christ, whom you sent to die for us so that we who believe in him will have life. We love you. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Now please remain standing for our national anthem performed tonight by Larray Brown.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red still there. Oh, see, does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free and the home of the
one final race, and then Kevin Harvick can officially celebrate his 2006 NASCAR Busch Series Championship. 300 miles tonight here at Homestead. When we come back, we'll have the command on TNT. NASCAR Busch Series Racing, the Ford 300 on TNT from the Homestead Miami Speedway, is brought to you by the Ford Shelby GT500. Bold moves, they happen every day. By Miller Lite. For great taste, there's no debate. Miller Lite, always a good call. And by Sirius Satellite Radio. The best radio on radio. Fans filing into the Homestead Miami Speedway as we close in on the command. There you see the championship standings with one race to go. And later on tonight, Kevin Harvick will celebrate his second championship in NASCAR Busch Series Racing. Hi, everybody. Bill Weber along with Wally Donnebach and Benny Parsons. Thanks for having us in for the race, the final race of 2006 for the NASCAR Busch Series. Now, Kevin Harvick has won the championship, but with 300 miles to go, some of these guys have a lot of work to do.
Really, Bill, because there's a lot of teams and drivers out there that don't have their deals set yet for next year. So this is a very important race, probably the most important race of the year for them. This is the one that they're going to be thinking about and working on for next year all winter long. So, yeah, there's a lot of guys. This is a very, very important race.
And they're doing it on a world-class facility. You know, this racetrack, they changed it two or three times in the past 2 years, and it is a quality racetrack. But in the chase for the NASCAR Nextel Cup, four of the top five are in this race tonight. Because it's an ever-changing racetrack. As it sits here for one summer, one hot, long summer in Miami, the racetrack has changed. And that's why four of the guys chasing Jimmy Johnson will be in the race tonight, trying to find the last-minute details that will help them tomorrow, hopefully, to win the NASCAR Nextel Cup.
Johnson is the championship leader in the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series. He does sit this one out. Benny, most of the practice for the Cup guys, in fact, all of it, was during the day. That race tomorrow night will finish under the lights.
And that's one reason they all wanted to be in this race tonight, to see what this racetrack is like green, you know, in the cool air of nighttime.
Now, you were on the track earlier today, Wally. Just tell us a little bit about it.
Well, it's a great racetrack. It used to be a flat racetrack. They put all this banking on it. I was down in turn one and two, and there's lines all over the place. There's a lot. Half the field was down on the bottom, and the other half was way up the top, and there's going to be some guys around the middle. So this is a great racetrack to finish out the season.
All right, we look forward to it. 300 miles for the stars of the NASCAR Busch Series in their finale in the 2006 season. The drivers all on board now, getting strapped in, helmets on, the belts pulled tight. 43 drivers ready for the final race of 2006. Right now, let's go trackside once again and get the command for tonight's race.
Race fans, are you ready? The time is now. The fans are fired up, and now it's time to get the cars fired up. Here's your Grand Marshal, Greg Wood.
Drivers, start your engines.
Homestead has been the final race of the season for the NASCAR Busch Series since 1995. The stars have come out at night in South Florida. When we come back, we'll take you to the green flag here at Homestead. He is the runaway point leader in 2006, Kevin Harvick. Winner tonight, Kevin Harvick wins at Richmond. Kevin Harvick wins at Kansas. Kevin Harvick wins again. Been an amazing season for Kevin Harvick, and later on tonight, the Clydesdales will deliver him the Busch Series Championship Trophy for 2006. 9 wins this season for Harvick. He goes for a record-tying 10th victory tonight here in Homestead. It's been a fantastic season for him, and he's had a lot of fun. And tomorrow he has an outside shot at the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series Championship, and we'll talk about that throughout the evening. Take a look at the starting grid for tonight's race. Harvick on the pole, next to J.J. Yaley, then Carl Edwards and Shane Huffman with a strong qualifying run. A lot of these guys went late in the qualifying session. Matt Kenseth and Bobby Labonte are in row 3.
Yeah, that was really a big help today. Hamlin, Boyer in row 4, Stephen Wallace, Ron Hornaday in 5, Rudiman, Casey Atwood in row 6.
Inside of row 7, Paul Menard, Brian Vickers, Dale Earnhardt Jr., and Daniel Quinn in row 8, Todd Cleaver, Brad Keselowski in row 9.
Drop back, take a look at row 10. Casey Kane's back there with Scott Wimmer. Aaron Crocker in row 11 next to Stephen Light. In row 12, Jason Leffler and Sam Hornish Jr. making another start in the NASCAR Busch Series. Take a look at the rest of the starting grid while BP jumps on the radio trying to get that guy in car 5.
Hey, Kyle Busch, BP, you got me?
Yeah, BP, good to hear you. Come on.
Well, you got an uphill struggle. What do you think?
I don't know. We'll see how it goes. The low spectrum side Chevrolet guys have really worked their butts off not only this weekend but the whole year in order to get us to this point. So we're not going to try to let them down now. We're going to go out here and give them a good final 300 miles of the year and see what we can work on to get better for next year.
Was the car pretty good in practice?
Well, we were back and forth a little bit, but mainly we were pretty loose. So. We'll see if hopefully the nighttime tightened us up a little bit to where we can try to come through the field a little bit here and see what we can get out of it. But overall, I think we'll be all right.
Sound like you're going to be perfect. Good luck.
All right, BP. Thanks, bud. Have a good night up there.
Thank you, Kyle. We hope to. Drivers get the two-to-go signal as they get to the line. Stories from pit road, and there will be a lot of them tonight. Let's get started. Here's Dave Burns.
And let's start with Bobby Labonte, a NASCAR Busch Series and Nextel Cup Series veteran. 178th start for Bobby in this series. 9 wins to his credit. A 10th tonight. Well, we'll see. He has won here at the Homestead Miami Speedway. Back in 2003, he won a Nextel Cup race here. That was his last Cup win. He hasn't won since then. And he does have a fast race car that he believes in. This is the same car he had at Texas just a couple weeks ago, and he finished in the top 10 that day. We'll see how it works out for Bobby Labonte. Matt?
Dave, it's a big night for Clint Boyer and the entire 2 team. Now, this is the final race for AC Delco, a sponsor that's had legendary success in the NASCAR Busch Series Championships with Dale Earnhardt Jr. and Harvick. And Boyer would love to send them off with a great trip to Victory Lane. Now, he's still digging, though, for that second spot in the championship standings. He's only 96 markers out, so you never know what can happen. He told me he slipped up in qualifying, tried a little too hard, the car got too loose, so he will start from the 8th position. But he says, in final practice, my car was awesome. Marty?
Well, Matt, it's been since mid-May that Denny Hamlin went to Victory Lane in the Busch Series. That came at Darlington. He told me it's been too long. And moments ago, he admitted to me, you know, he started the season very strong this year on the 20 team. Then we kind of lost focus midway through the year. Trying to regain that focus here in the last few weeks. Feel like our team has gotten better. But I really want to finish tonight with a top 5 or maybe a win. These guys deserve it. They've worked too hard for us not to have some success. Alan?
J.J. Yaley told me that the car he's driving in this race tonight, that 18 machine, has had a new body put on it for this race, one that contains all the latest and greatest aerodynamic knowledge that the Joe Gibbs Racing Engineering Group can come up with. Is it strong enough to get him his first Busch Series win tonight? He told me before the race, he hopes so. He'd like to finish the season on a strong note. He starts on the outside of the front row. Bill?
Thanks, Alan. Hope you guys enjoy the race down there tonight. Field gets the one-to-go signal on this mile-and-a-half track, and Benny talked about it. They've worked very hard to make this track one of the most exciting and entertaining tracks on the circuit. It's a great place to come and finish the season.
It started life as a rectangle like the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, but a mile and a half. And that didn't work out too well for stock cars.
And flat.
And flat.
Flattest board.
And then they made rounded corners, but still flat.
Right.
Because they'd still want to run the Indy cars here, the open wheel cars. But that didn't work out too well for stock cars either. So finally, they came up with this variable banking. Then on the bottom, it's 18 degrees. In the middle, it's 19. On top, it's 20 degrees. And I think it's a great facility.
Yeah, actually, the old racetrack was fun to drive. I think if you talk to the drivers, it was fun and it was challenging to drive, but it was just poor racing.
Yeah, poor racing.
So when they changed the racetrack, we've seen some really good racing since then.
Field coming around to get the green this time. Some people have been complaining that it is a cool night here in Florida. And by Florida standards, it is a little cool. 66 degrees right now.
But by Minnesota standards, it's perfect.
You're exactly right. And the weather forecast for tomorrow is just ideal.
Outstanding.
Sunny, temperature in the low 70s tomorrow. 200 laps, 300 miles tonight. About 62 to 65 laps, BP?
That's about right. You know, get to the end of the race and somebody has 70 laps to go, they may try, but they may run out of gas.
And we've seen that this year, haven't we?
Oh, gosh, have we ever.
Okay, the field moves through turns 3 and 4. Been a long season and a successful season for many of these teams. They've got 300 miles left, and they all want the same thing, a victory. Later on tonight, Kevin Harvick will be center stage, celebrating as the champion. He will bring the field to the green flag for the final race of 2006 for the NASCAR Busch Series. Glad you're along for the ride, live on TNT.
He's a little bit loose. Talking about the 18 car of Yaley. What did he do, spin the tires on the start?
Well, the start looked very slow. And there was a lot of guys that had trouble way there, way out the back. But he a little bit loose there in the 18 car. First lap, anyway.
J.J. Yaley said during qualifying they were going to lock Kevin Harvick in the men's room. That was the only way they were going to be able to stop him. He might have been right.
There's Stephen Wallace in the 64 car, Rusty's son. Bobby Labonte in 77, yellow car in front of him.
And that's what we're talking about, all those different grooves on this racetrack. I mean, it's really a fun place to drive because of that. And the track has got all those grooves now. We don't have to wait 20 or 30 laps. They worked it in practice the last couple days.
And this is what you'll see tonight and again tomorrow afternoon in the next Tel Cup Series race. A lot of side-by-side racing, a lot of passing. Update from pit road, here's Alan.
Just a quick confirmation that J.J. Yaley did jump on his radio and say, loose. Back end sliding around on him. That's not a bad thing as this race run goes along, though, because they expect the front end to lose grip as the tires get more laps on them.
There's Yaley in that 18 machine.
I like the line that he's running. You know, most of these cars are going in on the bottom of the racetrack and drifting up. He's going in about the middle. If he can sustain that, I think he's... Oh!
Sam Hornish Jr. First caution of the night.
Got a lot of right rear damage.
Obvious contact with the wall.
Now, Wally, you...
Lane here. Take time.
You've driven open-wheel cars.
Yes.
Sam Hornish won the Indy 500 this year, so we know he's world-class race car driver. What's the difference in stock cars? I've never driven Indy car.
Well, the Indy car, especially the IRL cars, those cars are really glued to the racetrack. They've got so much downforce and so much stick that you don't get the sliding around like these cars have. These cars feel like they're on top of the racetrack all the time, that they're on ice compared to like an Indy car. And they just get away from you fast. I mean, especially when you're not expecting it.
Sam Hornish brings out the first caution here in Homestead. Kevin Harvick is the race leader. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. TNT Sports live at the Homestead Miami Speedway in South Florida for 300, season finale for the NASCAR Busch Series. Under an early caution, and here is the start of the race.
If you watch back there in about the 10th or 12th row, a bunch of those guys got jammed up. The guys in the back just anticipated wrong, and it was pretty sloppy, although nobody ran into each other at least.
They were very fortunate.
Very, I agree with that, Bill. All right, light is out atop the pace car, means this time by another three quarters of a lap, back to green.
Pace vehicle takes him down the backstretch here. Kevin Harvick is the race leader. Then it's Carl Edwards, Matt Kenseth, J.J. Yaley, and Denny Hamlin. Clint Bowyer, Shane Huffman, Bobby Labonte, David Rudiman, and Stephen Wallace are your top 10. And Harvick, very strong at the start of the race and was pulling away.
Bad news for the competition.
Exactly right.
AB, how about the 39 car? What's up?
Well, the education of a champion. I think I used that phrase last week to describe Montoya. Indy 500 champion Sam Hornish is going to have an education as to what it's like limping a damaged race car around in one of these NASCAR races. That rear spoiler, the blade that provides all the downforce on the back end of the car, so much of the sheet metal on the right rear quarter panel of the car had to be cut away. That's not going to be a lot of help to him. And they might also have had to knock out some of the crush panels on the right side. He's going to get a lot of fumes in the car, too. Have fun, Sam.
Other than that, everything sounds pretty good for him, man.
Green flag, green flag, green flag.
Pull away again. There's Hamlin. Bobby Labonte.
And that 77 car that Bobby Labonte is driving is owned by Kevin Harvick, the leader of the race in the 21 car. He has his own race team, Kevin Harvick Incorporated, and hired Bobby Labonte here about a month ago, 6 weeks ago. He's doing a good job in that car.
Put him in there late in the season to try and help the team, find out how the equipment's doing.
Yeah, he's kind of like a little test driver, isn't he, Dave?
Yeah, with a whole bunch of experience. His commentary on that short little run, about three laps there at the start, just a little bit free in traffic, about what I expected, and the veteran motors on.
Clint Bowyer in the 2, Yaley in the 18.
That last lap by, Carl Edwards was faster than the leader, Kevin Harvick, by about 0.2 of a second. I'm sorry, 0.04 of a second. Excuse me. Big difference.
Kenseth was closing in on Edwards. Now Carl's pulled away a little bit for second. Harvick leads, Edwards second, Kenseth third. Matt Kenseth second. And the chase for the NASCAR Nextel Cup Championship, 63 points.
Marty, what's Carl saying in the 60 car?
Well, BP, I think his remarks reflect exactly what you were saying as he talks about his teammate Matt Kenseth trying to get underneath him a little bit. They were sharing some verbal spars at the beginning of the race. But Carl said that my car is very loose at the beginning of the run. I think it's going to be very good at the end of the run. I think we're about even with that 21 car, but obviously he was a little more worried about his teammate Matt Kenseth, who has now gotten around him, Alan.
Matt Kenseth just took the second spot away from Carl Edwards. Matt Kenseth winning the race last weekend out in Phoenix for the NASCAR Busch Series. Says he's had a great time racing this Busch Series car with Jimmy Fennig as the crew chief on this team this year. Said they've been capable of winning more weekends than not. And that's about all a race driver can ask.
Matt,
One driver on the move, the Blue Deuce, Clint Bowyer in the two car. The car is on the free side, which will really be good as this track tightens up as the race progresses. They feel like they're sitting in a pretty good position. Three laps ago, he just moved up to fourth, and he is chasing down Carl Edwards.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. in that eight car. They think about going three wide in front of him. Jr. started 16th. This is about 10th, 11th, and 12th right here. Rudiman in the 99. Dave, the 64, is in that group too.
Yep, and trying to stay ahead of the 99 right now. His dad, Rusty Wallace, radioed him before the start of the race. He said, now, I'm not going to stay on the radio here, but I do want to remind you, when you get down on the bottom, like he is right now underneath Rudiman, be very careful. Don't let your car get away from you and be loose. And he said, 10-4, Dad. Alan?
A 500 winning percentage in racing is pretty enviable. Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s run four Busch Series races this year. He's won two of them. This is fifth start tonight. He's looking to have a lot of fun in this race car. He's planning on running more Busch Series races next year. He took the green flag in 16th, and he's moved up smartly in these opening laps.
I think he's an example of how these guys are learning in the Busch Series races that it helps them on Sundays.
And I think he's going to move around tonight. He's going to try the bottom group. He's going to try the middle. He's going to try the top. Because winning the race is not important tonight. Learning is important.
Yeah, we can already see in the last couple laps, he's been in all those grooves that you just mentioned.
Rudiman's going to use the high line to try and get around Wallace.
That's the Michael Walters car. It only knows the high groove.
Junior will try and follow him through. Kevin Harvick is the race leader. Kenseth runs second. Then it's Edwards, Bowyer, and Yaley, the top five in the Ford 300. Enter the BK Race to Glory fantasy game. You could win a trip for two to the Atlanta race next spring. The game is free to play. Go to NASCAR.com and register. 20 laps complete here in Homestead. Kevin Harvick started on the pole, has led them all.
But he's got some competition moving up.
Yeah, Kenseth's been working that high line. It looks like it's been a little bit faster the last few laps. See, he's way up there high, and he gets a really good run right from there. Off the corner, down the back straightaway. It looks like a little bit faster than Kenseth. Harvick.
So Brad Keselowski's slow on the track a few moments ago. Dave Burns reporting trouble under the hood for the 23 car.
And he moved right up there, didn't he?
Yes, he
looked
in
the mirror and went, wow, that high line looks pretty good. I'll try that.
That's exactly right. I love that when they look in the mirror and just move around where the competitor is.
Now Kansas goes to the bottom.
This is for the lead, Kenseth. And Harvick coming right back. What'd you say about this being a competitive track?
I love this racetrack today. See, now Kenseth is on the 18 degree banking. The 21 cars in 20 degrees.
Usually right that part, getting off the corner, the guy in the high line has the advantage. He just has more momentum, more speed to pull down that straightaway. The guy in the bottom, like Kenseth, he's got to pull the pass off right almost three quarters of the way through so he can drift up in front of the car.
That's what he's trying to do.
Not quite there.
He could probably force
it. I think he could have got away with it.
And Harvick could probably have backed off, but it's early. There's no point in doing that.
Yeah, I think Harvick did back off right there. Just cracked the throttle a little bit and said, all right, let's see what you got.
New race leader, Matt Kenseth. Update on Harvick from Allen.
Yeah, a story from the man who was the race leader that I think we're going to hear from a lot of teams all night, Bill. He talks about his car being tight. That means the front end does not want to grip as much as he needs it to. And when that front end starts to slide, there's only so far you can go before you got a choice. Get out of the gas or hit the wall.
And talking to Matt Kenseth, I talked to his spotter just before I came in the booth today. Excuse me. And, you know, he struggled in practice today. But the second practice session, he felt like they're about as good as anybody here. Talking about the 17th DeWalt car over Nextel Cup.
He said,
that looks good.
He said they found something he can work with in that 17 car in that second practice.
Right. Paul Menard there in 11. Wallace in the 64 car. Casey Kane. Good group. Greg Biffle in the 16 right there. Cleaver.
Kyle Busch, the 5 car that I talked to on the radio, was in front of this group for
alongside the 9 car a few laps ago, but evidently he's got picked up that push and just cannot get back on the throttle the way he needs to.
Right there for about 12th spot. Looks like Casey Kane's trying to work his way through, Marty.
Yeah, Wally, he's come up to the 19th starting position with a car that's loose getting into the corners. So when he's in traffic like this, with all these cars in front of him, it makes his car work really well. Not so well when the 06 is behind him, but with cars in front, Casey said his car is really, really good.
Yeah, because what happens is when your car's loose and then you get in the traffic like that, it actually takes the air off the front of the nose. So that balances the car out when you're in traffic.
Another one of those Roush Couture's. Carl Edwards in that 60 car goes by Harvick now. Roush has cars running 1-2.
So Edwards to second, Harvick to third, behind leader Matt Kenseth. Back to this group. Benny talked about Kyle Busch. You see him in the 5 car, the tail of that pack.
And Kyle's getting the worst of the air right now. You know what? He's behind all these cars, and his car's probably the biggest handful because all that air is just tumbling in front of you, and he's just trying to wait till that all sorts out a little bit and then try to pick them off one by one.
Cleaver looking inside of Wallace. Through turn 2. There's Busch again in that 5 car, trailing those cars. Matt?
Bill, it's been a long time since that Bristol win back in the spring, and he would love to put a period on the 2006 season with a victory. But Kyle Busch says the car is good now, but his concern is that means it's going to be bad as we hit the latter stage of this run. We're about halfway through a fuel run, so he's expecting that car to start to go tighter and tighter. Right now, running in the 17th position.
I don't think he's having a lot of fun right now.
Not right now. When they're driving away, that's not a lot of fun.
Kane in the 9. Biffle in the 16. On board, Biffle. 30 laps complete. Matt Kenseth out front again. He's the leader in the Ford 300 at Homestead on TNT. Tiger Woods, Jim Furyk, Jeff Ogilvy, and Mike Weir battle it out in the PGA Grand Slam of Golf, live from the Poipu Bay Golf Course in Kauai, Hawaii. Coverage begins 7 p.m. Eastern, Tuesday on TNT. Love watching that. Never hurts to be sitting there looking at Hawaii, does it?
Especially in December.
And that Tiger guy's playing.
Or no, late November, I should say.
Yeah.
And that Tiger guy, yeah. He didn't win the last tournament.
Imagine that.
Only finished second. Yep. No, gone it.
37 laps are complete. Working lap 37, actually. Matt Kenseth, the race leader, starting to lap some of the guys in the back of the field. Time to take you through the field. Let's start with that.
And up front with Matt Kenseth, who started 5th, took the lead from Kevin Harvick, seeking his 3rd win of the season in the NASCAR Busch Series, and what would be his 2nd straight after a victory last Saturday in Phoenix. No problem so far for car 17. Marty.
Alan Carl Edwards doing all he can to catch his teammate. He finished 19th in this race last year. He told me earlier today, I hated that feeling all winter long, knowing we didn't perform well in that final race. I'm determined to do a little bit better today. So the car getting much better the longer they run here. Matt.
Cliff Boyer started the day out in the 8th position. He just climbed up to 3rd, passing his teammate Kevin Harvick back on lap 35. The car, much like it was halfway through this run, it is still on the loose side. He says, too loose, just can't wait for that first pit stop to fix it, AB.
Goal sitter Kevin Harvick, about 12 laps ago, called in and said, really big adjustment, Shane. Shane being Shane Wilson, his crew chief. Harvick wants some help with that car. J.J. Yaley started on the front row in 2nd spot. He has dropped back now to the, well, he was in 6th, he just moved up to 5th position. And Yaley and his crew chief already discussing the adjustment they want on their first pit stop to try and help him with the back end grip on that car. Marty?
Alan, Denny Hamlin is driving a car today that his teammate Tony Stewart drove at Kansas a few weeks ago. He finished 2nd with it in that race. The car was sitting in the corner of the shop doing nothing. It's more like the 07 cars are on next year. So they decided to bring it here. Denny has had one comment on the radio, a little loose. That's it. Alan?
Here's the guy making the early charge, Dale Earnhardt Jr. started 16th. You see, he's moved up to the seventh spot. Junior's comments on the radio to his team, really good car, just making laps. Right behind him is Brian Vickers in the 57 car. Vickers on his last weekend driving for Hendrick Motorsports, making his eighth Busch Series start of the season. He has fallen back with a car that won't turn in the corners to his liking. Marty?
Alan, the fastest car on the track right now is Paul Menard. He has really come to life in the second half of this run using the high line, but it's taken about 25 laps for that car to come in. Paul said on the radio that that may be too long for it to come in later in the run. They're going to have to work on that. He started loose, obviously, very, very fast right now. Todd Cleaver having a very impressive run. Talked to this young man earlier today. He told me, you know what? I didn't get the six ride this year, and I need to prove that I belong here, not only in the Busch Series, but maybe the Nextel Cup Series someday. What I need to do, finish these races. We've run well in them. I have to finish right now in the top 10. Matt.
And the 88 team just faded outside the top 10. A great run last week for Shane Huffman. Led 17 laps in Phoenix. Scored a top 10 finish. First time he's ever led laps in NASCAR Busch Series competition. The car, though, tight on entry and 2-3 on exit.
David Brudeman started this last run in the ninth position, but has gone backwards. His car is very, very loose going in. A lot of information coming back to him, including from car owner Michael Waltrip, who said you might want to try this or that. The crew radio back. We got that on the same page. Boss, we'll try that on the first stop. Marty?
Well, Dave, earlier we told you Casey Kane's car was very loose. Now it's all of a sudden gone extremely tight. He said, I don't know why this happens to me every week, but it seemed like a switch went off. Now the front tires don't work. I'm tied into the corner, and it's too loose coming off the corner. We have a lot of things to fix on this nine car, Dave.
Steve Wallace was losing position, so his crew radioed to him, is your car getting tight? Three laps later, after Steve drove in a big pack of traffic, he finally radioed back in. Yes, tight everywhere. They'll make some changes on the next stop. Marty, back to you.
Dave, a lot of work so far for Greg Biffle, who started 26th, but he has said nothing to his crew. We asked Jack Roush how the car was. He said, it looks good to me. Started 26th up to 15th, has made his way smartly through the field. After this next stop, they expect more good things, Bill.
Thanks, Marty. That is the top 15. Then it's Bobby Labonte, Ron Hornaday, Kyle Busch, Stacy Compton, and Jason Leffler, the top 20. Right now, 25 cars run on the lead lap in the fourth 300. Matt Kenseth is the race leader. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. Caution has just come out here at Homestead. Reed Sorensen escaping his car, which was being engulfed in flames. Pulled it into the grass, quickly climbed out.
Sure, look, you know, BP, I'm not sure, busted an oil line or what there, but the biggest thing in a driver, and it's not even, you'll see this shot, it's not even so much the fire at this point, it's all that smoke inside the car, that you're inhaling all that, you can't see, and you want to get out. Now it's probably getting a little bit warm, but that smoke is probably bothering more than anything.
At least it doesn't look like the flames were able to get inside,
right.
That the firewall between the engine and the driver compartment held up. The transmission boot is now made of a material that doesn't burn, so. But while you're in there, you've got to be very concerned. I think it looks like an engine, but what happens is the oil, when the engine breaks and the piece of the block comes apart, that oil scatters on the exhaust system, which is about 1,000 degrees.
Yeah, you can see it pouring out the bottom there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Come on, brake. Stop. Stop. Let me out of here.
He's already unbuckling while that thing's still rolling. Sorensen is 10th in the championship standings as of right now. Obviously, his night is done.
Who's he battling, Kenny Wallace?
Yes. And right now, Wallace is 83 points behind. Just one of a handful of points battles being waged here tonight in the season finale for the Busch Series. 46 laps are complete. Pit road will be open next time they come around.
And when the cars make a pit stop here, they can't come off turn four and drive on the pit road. They've got to go in the pits. The commitment line, or they've got to enter the pits about 100 yards from here, entering turn three. As you see, Matt Kenseth and all the guys moving down to make that first pit stop.
Now, one thing about this, too, you know, obviously, under yellow, it's a piece of cake.
Right.
But when you're trying to hustle and trying to make up time here,
that pit lane is real tricky because it's flat and it's dirty and you're trying to go as fast as you can. And we've seen a lot of guys lose it on pit lane during green conditions.
And you say, well, why don't Kenseth speed up? Because you cannot pass the pace car under caution conditions. He has to stay level with him. And when he gets to pit road speed limit is going to be 45 miles per hour.
Pit stops, Matt.
And the AC Delco guys up on the wall waiting for Cliff Bowyer, looking for a chassis adjustment. They're also calling for air pressure adjustment and putting on scuffs. The car just way too free during that entire run. The car never tightened up as the fuel load burned off. Marty?
Matt, Carl Edwards is in the middle of your screen. The second he hits pit road, he said, whatever the 17 is running for air pressures, that's what I want in my car. A little too loose to start the run, so they're going to put a half round in the left rear, Alan.
Leader Matt Kenseth, top left of the screen. A right front air pressure adjustment down. Says his car is okay in the bottom groove, needs help up high. They're also keeping an eye on the water temperature. Dave?
David Ruderman came in 12th, and they made an air pressure adjustment and two tires on David's car to try to fix that loose-in condition. Pretty good pit stop for the 99 bunch.
Oh, man. And Harvick beats them all out.
Pays to win the pole, doesn't it, BP?
Oh, it does. What a great pit stall he is.
Take a look at the race off of pit road. There goes Harvick, then Edwards, then Kenseth. So Kenseth went in the leader, came out third under caution at Homestead. If you're not watching the race on a Sony high-definition TV, what are you watching? Nine laps complete here in Homestead. Casey Atwood.
That's some strategy I don't quite understand.
Has stayed out, and he is scored as the race leader.
I mean, he's got to come in 15 laps or less
and get fuel. So maybe he's going to make his pit stop. Maybe we just wanted to be out front.
Get a little TV time, get to know the pace car.
Mm-hmm. Goes.
So now he heads for pit road. Then it's Harvick, Edwards, Kenseth, Yaley, and Bowyer. Earnhardt, Hamlin, Menard, Cleaver, and Kane. Under caution, working cleanup after Reed Sorensen's car erupted in flames. He's okay. On his way to the care center. TNT Sports at the Ford 300 in Homestead, Florida. Final race for the NASCAR Busch Series in 2006. Field getting the one to go. Be green next time by. Let's check in with Dave Burns.
And good news is Reed Sorensen walked out of the care center in his own power. Did you inhale any of those fumes, though, Reed? That was pretty smoky.
I tried not to stay in there long enough to get any of them, that's for sure. Got out as quick as I could. And I think that's the first time I've ever had to do that, is actually get out while it was on fire. So just got out as quick as I could there, and feel bad for the guys. You know, they worked hard all year long, and we've had stuff like this happen to us all year long. So just regroup over the winter. We can definitely build fast race cars, and I still believe in those guys. So we'll just come back next year and come back strong.
And you did see the oil light going down into turn one?
Yeah, you know, actually in practice last night, the car felt really good, and it was just running okay lap times. And, you know, I told them the motor didn't feel too good then, so we may have had an issue from the start there, and obviously it didn't go far tonight. And the oil light did come on going into one, and it blew up coming off two. So whatever happened, it happened pretty quick.
Tough end of the season for Reed, but he walked away from that, Bill.
Thank you, Dave. John Andretti in the 10 car is the lucky dog. The field doubling up behind the pace vehicle. And we'll go back to green when they get to the line. Harvick, Edwards, Kenseth, Yaley, and Bowyer, the top five. And Harvick has been pretty good on restarts.
You know, he hired Ron Hornaday Jr., and Ron Hornaday Jr. is the king of restarts. And it looks like he has taught Harvick something
green
about
flag,
that.
Green flag, green flag, green flag.
I would have put that in the contract.
Look at that. Look at the jump that he got on the 60 car of Edwards.
Now Edwards will have to deal with some of the lap cars. Stephen Wallace is around on the back stretch. Caution is out.
Well, he's successful. He knocked every one of them over.
He missed one. And he's taking one with him.
Yeah, just in case. Boy, he's got some
serious. All right, come on down pit road. Right, you're pushing a cone here, kind of wiggle the car. Let's not get that cone stuck on the front.
Oh, my they just got
four abreast.
Actually, the 38 car looked like it hooked the 77 car. Looked like Jason Leffler got into Bobby Labonte, turned Labonte into Stephen Wallace.
And the aforementioned Ron Hornaday in the 33 car has a lot of damage.
Yes, he does.
Now, somebody got into Leffler first.
I think it was Hornaday.
Yeah.
Not sure. Shouldn't say things like that until I'm positive.
But there wasn't enough room regardless of who got into who.
Four wide doesn't fit off two. Yeah. We found that out. Look at the grass. That's an awesome shot.
There's Wallace sliding through the grass.
Okay, you got that one. That one, that one, that one.
Well, you hit them all, honey.
He hit them all.
On board with left one.
Nothing off the wall, stay in the middle here.
Ooh.
Oh, geez. Got wrecked here, guys.
Now, that shot looked like Wallace came down on left.
Mm-hmm, it did. A nice shot. This is on board with Juan Pablo Montoya.
Say, by Watson here. Checked up. Nobody behind you. Nobody behind you. Come through there. Come on. You're good. Good. Get out of there. Clear.
Juan probably hasn't heard that accent a lot on his radio. Under caution, Regan Smith is the lucky dog. Harvick is the race leader. Still under caution here at Homestead Miami Speedway in the Ford 300. 55 laps are complete. Kevin Harvick is the race leader. Under caution after a multi-car crash following the restart. Go back and take another look.
You watch high the 59 car. Stacy Compton gets a little bit loose up on the high side. He gets a little bit loose. Stephen Wallace ducks down to try to get in between him. Leffler's there. He makes contact with Leffler, and that just starts this whole chain reaction. Just came down to everybody was trying to squeeze through, you know, too small a spot. Everybody ran out of room.
Marty?
Well, Bill, let's get some perspective from the man who was in the middle of all that, Ron Hornaday. What happened to start that? Do you know?
I really don't know. I just know there's some lappers up there who had some used tires, some guys trying to get spots. And it looked like Compton was up at top, and there was a couple lappers on the inside. And Bobby and I come out the corner, and it looked like somebody moved up into the 38, hit the 77, turned around, and got back inside the outdoor channel Chevrolet. These guys don't deserve it. Awesome race car. We ran this at Texas, and we just got a handle on it right there. We just made some changes, and the outdoor channel Chevrolet was going to be good. So I got to thank all the guys. They work hard, and hate to end the year this way, but Kevin Lane, we'll go out there and try to keep our spots and points.
This is the team that had some terrific momentum coming into Homestead. As he mentioned, the car they finished fifth with at Texas, but it's going to be a long night now for Ron Hornaday after they make the repairs. He will get back out.
Thank you, Marty. We've already heard from a couple of guys tonight exactly what you said before the race went green. This is the one you remember
offseason. I mean, this is the last one, and that's the one you remember.
Watch Harvick on the restart.
I don't know if Carl Edwards is going to be sleeping this much this time. He got as good a start as Harvick did.
It's like Biffle was not able to get going on the.
Got something wrong.
There's something bad wrong. It's in neutral.
One more, clear to the bottom.
So he coasts down to the apron.
Looks like he broke the transmission, is what it sounds like, or gear.
What you got, bud? Nothing. Just no power, no nothing.
Transmission or.
Simple, bring it to us. We'll see what we got.
Harvick, Edwards, Kenseth.
Anyway, Harvick and Edwards look like they left together. It just looked like Harvick's car accelerated a lot better than Carl Edwards' car.
Earnhardt in the 8. Ashton Lewis Jr. in that 25.
Earnhardt's car's been pretty good. He's been slowly working his way up.
But it looks like the eight cars run very, very good times, a lot of lap times towards the end of that run that were better than the guys in front of them. AB, what's he saying?
Well, Wally, he's saying a lot, but nothing about the race car. You'd figure during a caution like that, if a driver had some things he wanted to pass on to his crew about the handling of his car, he might take the time to do it. Dale Earnhardt Jr. had about a five-minute monologue under that caution on a variety of topics, none of which included the handling of his race car. It's real stream of consciousness stuff. He must have a great car because he seems like he's in a great mood.
Now that, if you're not talking about the car, then you've got a good one.
Caution is out again.
Like Augie Vojtovic may have brushed the wall getting out of turn four.
Yeah, four hit four, huh?
Four hit four.
This would be our fifth, check that, our fourth caution of the race.
He's saying you're loose off the corner now?
Loose through the whole corner now.
I see a lot of smoke. It looks like he might have just brushed the wall. As a matter of fact, he's not going to pit road.
So under caution here at Homestead, BP, you gonna go home watch the end of this?
Yeah, I think I will. Okay. I'll go back to the hotel, rest up, because tomorrow, big day. We got to crown a Nextel Cup champion tomorrow.
I think I'll go with you, BP.
Come on. Bill, you can handle it, can't you?
I'll be right here. You guys have a safe trip, okay?
Thanks.
BP, right, we'll see you in the morning.
Have a great show, fellas.
All right. Under caution here at Homestead in the Ford 300, Kevin Harvick is the race leader. NASCAR Busch Series Racing, the Ford 300 on TNT from the Homestead Miami Speedway is brought to you by Smooth Busch Beer and Easy Drinking Busch Light. Busch, proud sponsor of the NASCAR Busch Series. By Energizer, keep going. And by New York Life, the company you keep. Field getting the one to go here at Homestead. Go back and look at a couple of things here. Here's the last restart. Watch Biffle.
In a 16 car, I don't know if he went to a gear and it wasn't there. I tell you, Rudiman did a really good job avoiding the 88 car of Shane Huffman.
And Huffman did a good job avoiding the 16.
Yeah.
This is on board with Biffle. Listen.
It just sounded like when he was going to a gear, nothing was there. Oh, I bet you Biffle can shed some light on this. Marty?
I bet he can, Wally. He enjoyed those replays, by the way. You finally had a good race car, and then what happened?
The transmission let loose on it. Must have, you know, when I went to third gear there on the restart, must have lost the gearbox. But, you know, the AmeriCorps Fusion running really good, excited about running good again in the Busch Series. Thought I was going to get up there and mess with Carl and Harvick and my teammate Matt, but not tonight, I guess.
And I know you're eighth in the championship standings right now. This will probably put that in jeopardy a little bit.
Yeah, so it's obviously going to move us from 8th to 9th. Last year, I got 10th by 1 point. So this year, I'm probably going to slip a few spots in the points. That'll cost us money, but we had a good season, and I look forward to coming back and running some more races next year.
Always important to make the stage in Orlando, Bill.
Absolutely, Marty. Green flags in the air. Harvick is going to try and break away again.
And guess what?
You must have different gears in those things, in those boxes, because I'll tell you what, Harvick gets a great restart.
Kenseth ducks back in line. Behind Carl Edwards. Kenseth using the low line. Again falls back in behind. Smoker down there behind them. Jason Leffler. Boyer inside of Yaley.
Fourth spot.
Here comes Earnhardt. Fourth, fifth, and sixth right there. Now three wide, maybe down the front stretch, maybe not. Hamlin. That 20 car.
Oh, trouble. Oh, Kyle Busch.
Kyle Busch.
Looks like Shane Huffman.
Huffman's backed it into the wall.
lot of damage on the five of Kyle Busch. And Huffman will limp his car back to pit road. Let's go back and see if we can find out what happened here.
Looks like the five car just got loose. Looks like he just got a little bit loose getting into one there. Not sure what happened to Huffman. Looks like he got loose the same time. The five was a little bit too close to Ruderman. And that'll happen on these fast racetracks. If you go into the corner side by side, too close to the guy on the outside, the guy on the inside loses the air on the spoiler and spins out. That's what happened to Kyle Busch.
Wow, fortunate to get across the track in traffic there. Under caution again here at Homestead.
A little bit loose off of two. He sideways.
Oh,
and he got turned. So you got an angry race car driver that's going to go out and try to settle the score right now with Junior.
One of the many moments from an exciting season of NASCAR Busch Series racing. Carl Edwards and Dale Earnhardt Jr. with a little bonding moment there. Marty, you work in the care center down there?
Well, I'm working in the garage, and unfortunately I found Shane Huffman, and we got to stop meeting like this. What happened?
I don't know. It looked like the 99 and the 5 was too close together getting in the corner there, and must have took the air off Kyle's spoiler or something. I'm not sure, but... just a victim of circumstances on this deal, and you know, it's just trying to be patient, sit there and ride and finish one of these deals out, and the professionals made a mistake here, I guess, so it's the way it goes.
This is a team that has been running so well lately, they just cannot buy a break. Alan.
That is Greg Biffle on top of Matt Kenseth's pit box, having a conversation with Matt out in the car. On the radio that was on the head of Robbie Reiser a minute ago. Robbie's down here watching. I don't want to know what's going on there, do I?
Probably not.
All right, let me ask you, you're sitting down here, you're listening to the radio transmissions. What are you listening for? We always hear about people trying to learn things. What are you listening for?
Well, I'm just trying to gain some knowledge for tomorrow night, see what the track's going to do. I mean, obviously we're going to be in total different conditions than what this is, but right now we seem to be behind the eight ball, and we're trying to get our cars better, and so I'm trying to gain as much as I can as this race is going by.
It's going to be hard to gain when Biffle's talking to your driver like that. You might have to get that radio back.
I think you're just having some fun. This is fun for those guys. So Greg's out because of transmission trouble, so they're having a little bit of fun.
Thanks, Robbie. Good luck tomorrow.
Thanks a lot.
Mike's Allen, good job. Matt Kenseth will start 19th tomorrow. Championship leader Jimmy Johnson qualified 15th for tomorrow's Ford 400. You'll see that on NBC. We're under caution at Homestead.
Thursday. Closer all-day event on TNT is here. See the entire first season.
Sirens, everyone.
Go, go, go!
And don't miss the Closer's all-new two-hour special event, December 4th and 8th. The Closer, all-day Thursday on TNT.
Still under caution, cleaning up the track here at Homestead. Kevin Harvick is the race leader. There are now 24 cars on the lead lap. John Wood was the lucky dog under the previous caution, Ashton Lewis Jr., the lucky dog under this caution period. It's Harvick, Edwards, Kenseth, Bowyer, and Yaley. Then Earnhardt, Hamlin, Kane, Menard, and Todd Cleaver, the top 10. Dave?
Checking in with Kyle Busch now, who's been released from the infield care center. You okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
What happened getting underneath the 99 there?
Well, first off, I want to thank my guys. You know, the low spectrum side Chevrolet was decent tonight. It wasn't excellent, but we were just biding our time, making our way up through there, just running a steady race. And I think I lost a friend in David Ruderman there. For some reason, the past three laps, he'd been running me terrible. I mean, putting me in behind lap cars, side drafting me down a straightaway, forcing me lower in order to block me behind lap cars and everything. And then got under him down the front straightaway there, and going into one, he didn't give me any room on the outside. He sucked all the air off my car. And when you don't have any side force, you're just along for the ride. So hit pretty hard, but hopefully I'll be all right for tomorrow.
You mentioned your guys working hard for you. They've worked hard this weekend. That's your second race car.
Yeah, that's our second race car. The first one's not terrible, but this one's pretty banged up.
Okay, we're glad you're okay. Kyle is
Going to go get ready for the next Cup race tomorrow, guys, but this Busch day is over.
Thank you, Dave. Field getting the one to go signal. We'll go green next time by. Now at Sunoco, NASCAR race points. Every 10-gallon fill-up earns you 200 race points. Good toward cool NASCAR rewards. During the chase for the cup, every race point you earn is a chance to win the chase for the race point sweepstakes. Get your race points at Sunoco today. Go to NASCAR.com or a participating Sunoco location for details. Hey, Marty, what are you doing?
I'm hanging out actually with J.D. Gibbs, and we're talking about Denny Hamlin's birthday. What are you doing, Weber?
I just wanted to know if Carl Edwards had talked much about Kevin Harvick's restarts.
Other than calling them jackrabbit restarts, he hasn't said a whole lot, and obviously he's been very impressed. I did ask Corner Day, did you give your car owner any tips on restarts? He said no, he was already good enough. So, but Carl is very impressed with his restarts.
Okay, we'll see how that works out. Because Harvick has been extremely strong on these restarts. He has led 47 laps of the 73 completed so far. Matt Kenseth has led 24. Juan Montoya and Casey Atwood both led a lap under caution, the four race leaders so far tonight in the Ford 300.
Pace car's off. Stay ready.
Just accelerates better than Carl Edwards. Carl Edwards looks like he's getting on the gas at the same time, but Harvick just takes off.
Brian Vickers, who was running in the top five, pitted under that caution for fuel, restarted 23rd. See how that works out for him.
Seven car, Joe Nemechek has been sparking a lot. And a lot down the straightaway, too. Not sure what he's got dragging on that car. Hopefully won't break.
Yes. Here's the race for third. Clint Bowyer trying to get underneath Matt Kenseth. Bowyer takes the position for now. Alan?
Well, I don't know what kind of advice Matt Kenseth might have gotten from Greg Biffle there on that radio under the caution, but Matt's car seemed to be better in the opening run of the race as laps went on. He seemed to need a few laps to get going, whereas Kevin Harvick seemed to get going quickly and then come back to the pack. So we'll see what happens here, although Matt giving up that spot to Clint Bowyer kicks him back to fourth.
Thanks, Alan. We'll keep our eye on that. There's Earnhardt, Denny Hamlin. That's for sixth.
Man, this has been a pretty good pack.
Stephen Wallace on the inside.
These guys are just stacked up. Get the whole track covered.
Montoya in the 42. There you see Hamlin and Earnhardt for position. Casey Kane's right there in the upper box left. There's Vickers in that 57, who stopped under the last caution. They will watch all this. Alan, what are you watching?
I'm watching that 8 car in the box on the upper left there, Bill. Okay, so the monologue on this last caution was basically his team asking him why he didn't get up there and pass a few more of those guys, and he said, well, they're no fun to pass because they're hard to pass. He said, when you start 25th and you pass those first 10 or 15, that's a lot more fun. It's a lot easier.
Hamlin is sixth. Earnhardt and Casey Kane behind him. Kane using the low groove. They try and close in on Nemechek. Kane gets the position from Earnhardt. And Menard trails that battle. Marty on Casey Kane.
Well, Bill, he was trying the low groove, not by decision, but because that junior was taking away his line. He likes to run that high groove. So the only way to get around him was to run the low groove. Casey Kane on the radio said, guys, the car is much better after that last stop than came on a couple seconds later. That's not to say we can make it even better than what it is right now either.
Get a chance to work on it next time they pit. You see how Casey Kane has progressed through the race.
But that's good. He can go down to the bottom and make that pass. A lot of times your car gets stuck into a groove where only that one groove works. But like Marty said, he got over there to the eight.
And those other drivers know Casey normally likes that high
side. Yeah.
Denny Hamlin trying to get around Joe Nemechek, and his car continues to spark.
Yeah, I'm not sure what that is. It's kind of strange, but look at Nykar gets a real good run there. He's trying to get on the high. Now, Nemechek is a lap down in 25th position.
So Kane gets around Nemechek. Hamlin in sixth. Casey Kane is seventh. Earnhardt Jr. has slipped back a little bit. He's in eighth. Menard is closing in on him for the position. Up front, it's Harvick, Edwards, and Clint Bowyer runs in the third spot. Matt.
And his spotters told him just to be patient. They are starting to slowly work their way back to him. The first guy is looking to race by is the 60 of Edwards. Now, he did make a comment about on the first run, the car was just so free. He wanted to try to play around a little bit and learn something for tomorrow's race. Still trying to knock down his first Nextel Cup victory, but the car was so free, he was just trying to keep a hold of it. Now he's got his mirror to the 17. Still trying to chase down another Roush car. The car's good now, Bill.
Thanks, Matt. Running well here tonight. Clint Bowyer in that two car. Edwards is second, and Harvick is the race leader in that 21 car. 9 wins this season. He's chasing the record tonight in Homestead. Tomorrow, we're right back here at Homestead for the season finale and the championship event for the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series. The Ford 400, our NBC Sports coverage, begins at 2 o'clock Eastern time with the Bank of America countdown to green. Then the final race of the year, 5 drivers eligible for the Nextel Cup Championship. Jimmy Johnson is the leader by 63 points over Matt Kenseth. Kevin Harvick, that 21 car, one of the drivers still mathematically alive in the chase. He's the race leader right now, but look at these guys closing in on him.
Well, we saw at the start of the race, Kenseth was a little bit loose. It seems like he needs to get his pressures up after a pit stop. He needs to get those tire pressures up before he starts going fast. He's going fast right now. He's been using that high line, and he closed the gap between him and the leaders very quickly. And here we got a change for the lead right now as the 60 of Carl Edwards is going to go by, and Kenseth is going to go by Harvick. And this is kind of the point in the run where Harvick's car last time started sliding back.
And Kenseth may not be content with second side by side at the stripe. And off into one.
Looks like he's got enough to slide up, and he'll take the spot.
Marty?
Well, guys, Carl Edwards wanted lap times, and he wanted details about Harvick and Kenseth, where they were faster than him and where he was slower than they were. And obviously, he's a little bit better in the middle of the corner than he was Harvick earlier on. Now he's trying to catch his teammate, Matt Kenseth. And as he went by, he told a spotter, tell his team thank you. He's very kind as he went by me.
The lap car of Bobby Labonte there, 77.
Labonte was involved in that, one of those earlier wrecks.
Now Harvick to the inside of the car he owns. So it's Kenseth, Edwards, Harvick, the top three. So what's this track like as far as, is it smooth, is it rough?
It's smooth. It just depends on how your car's set up. We've got a great shot here on Stephen Light's car on the right there, Carl Edwards on the left. Now you look at Light, he's using a lot of ham in that steering wheel. And that tells me that he doesn't feel the car underneath him. When you move the wheel like that, you're searching for grip. You're searching for the feel in the steering wheel. On the other hand, Carl Edwards is not using it that much. He feels the grip, so he's not moving that wheel around to search for it through the steering wheel. So Carl Edwards got obviously a very good handle on the race car. Looks like Stephen Light is struggling a little bit.
Stephen runs back in the 30th spot. Edwards currently second. That's good stuff. Here's race leader Matt Kenseth. As soon as the longer he goes, the better he gets. And he is going to try and pull away from Edwards and Harvick and Bowyer and Yaley. A little over a second lead for Matt Kenseth. There's Greg Biffle. Went to the garage with transmission issues earlier in the night.
And obviously these guys are trying to stay in the top 10 in points. That's why Biffle's coming back out. Right now he sits ninth in points.
Reed Sorensen, 10th in points, is out of the race. Kenny Wallace is 11th and is closing in on that 10th position.
Actually, Biffle's pretty close to getting 8th in points right now.
Good. From Sauter. It's Clint Bowyer in the 2, J.J. Yaley in the 18, Allen.
Let's talk about this 18 car, Bill, trying to make a rally. Remember, he started on the front row, slipped back in the opening part of the race. The reason was his car was loose entering the corner. That means when the car started to turn left into the corner, the back end wanted to spin around on him. That's a very easy way to crash a race car at a high-speed track like this. They made an adjustment on the pit stop. Now his lap times are almost every bit as good as Matt Kenseth's. In fact, on some laps, they're even a little bit better. Yaley's hanging in there.
Thanks, Alan. I heard Yoakum talking earlier before we went on the air. I believe it's JJ's grandmother's 81st birthday today. Zola, I believe. So we wish her a happy birthday. JJ wanted to make sure we passed that along. Matt Kenseth, the race leader. JJ's back there in fourth in the Ford 300. Hey, Wally, somebody moved your truck.
Yeah.
Remember where you parked?
Should be easy to find.
Some of the goings on outside the Homestead Speedway. Inside the Ford 300, just past the halfway mark. Our Energizer lap leaders. Harvick has led 64 laps. Kenseth, the current race leader, 35. Carl Edwards led a lap. Montoya and Atwood both led a lap under caution. Our Energizer lap leaders in the Ford 300. Matt Kenseth is the current leader by 4 seconds over Carl Edwards last time at the line. Let's take you through the field. Alan, the longer it goes, the better he gets.
Pretty much the report from inside that 17 car, Bill. Matt radioing to crew chief Jimmy Fennig a minute ago. He said it's good, it just takes a while to get going. Green flag pit stops between 10 and 15 laps away for the leaders, including Kenseth. Marty.
Alan, Carl Edwards in second is asking the same question he was asking an hour ago. Are you sure we have the same air pressures as that 17 car? Because obviously he's a little bit better than we are. As the run goes on, Carl's car falls off. It's too tight here at the end of the run, meaning it will not turn. They need to make it better if they want to catch their teammate, AB.
Kevin Harvick's telling his team he needs another adjustment like he had in the last pit stop to try and free the car up. That means start it with less rear grip so that as the conditions change over the course of a tire run and the front end loses grip, the car balances out. Harvick trying to take a defender spot here from J.J. Yaley, who's trying to take third from him. Yaley's lap times holding their speed as this run goes on. The driver who started second slipped back in the top 10, now trying to work his way toward the front. Matt.
And Clint Bowyer, who was on the move, now is starting to fade back down the scoring. 7.5 seconds back of the lead. He's lost about 2 seconds over the last 7 laps. He really hasn't said much about the handling of the race car. He is just now, Marty, moving around the racetrack, trying to find a better line to help the balance of the car.
Matt, Paul Menard is flying. Once again, at the end of the run, he's the fastest race car. Problem is, they lose so much ground at the beginning of the run that they have to make changes to try and get this car a little bit better. They're lapped about 20 laps or so from making their next stop. Behind him on the racetrack, Denny Hamlin, whose car is starting to get tight at the end of the run. As we mentioned earlier today is his birthday, number 26 for Denny Hamlin. No better birthday present, of course, for Denny.
then a win. Currently, he's in the seventh position. Todd Cleaver, his car a little bit too tight at the end of the run as well, but having a terrific day up in the top 10 for most of the afternoon. He wants to make very slight changes. They need to be better at the beginning of the run. He, too, feels like he's giving up too much ground there. Alan?
Just listening to radio transmission come in a second ago and trying to shut it off in my ear. The Dale Earnhardt Jr. car continues to struggle right there in the center of the corners, what he's telling his crew. When he gets into the middle of the corner, the car just wants to go right up to the top of the racetrack, and he runs out of pavement. He has to lift out of the gas. It's costing him spots. Marty?
Casey Kane, Alan has a laundry list of things he would like for the 9 crew to fix this time. He said the car is just so tight going into the corner, he has to wait on the gas, but when he hits it, the car wants to spin out a little bit. They are a little shorter on fuel than everybody else. They're only about 6 laps from their next stop. Bill?
Thanks, Marty. That's a top 10 through the field. There are currently 20 cars scored on the lead lap. You heard Alan talk about pit stops coming. We'll duck out, come back, watch the guys come get fuel and tires. 109 laps complete in the 4-300. Matt Kenseth is the race leader.
Green flag pit stops just beginning here at the Homestead Miami Speedway. Lap 115 just going on the board. Casey Kane running in the top 10 told his guys the car is much better. We need just a little bit. I want to keep running that high line, but when I do, my car is a little too tight. Half pound out of both left side tires and a wedge adjustment as well for the 9 car. Alan?
Warning Dale Earnhardt Jr. to watch his pit road speed. It'd be very costly to get a penalty coming down this very long Homestead Miami Speedway pit road and have to do that under green in a pass-through. Junior's car, we talked about needing some help in the center of the corner with the front end grip. Tony Urey Jr. calling him into his pit stall now. They'll make a 4-tire change and also make a chassis adjustment. They've made some air pressure adjustments already on the car. Now, with the difference between new tires and older tires, once the first of these leaders has hit pit road, watch for everybody to come rushing in quickly, because for these next few laps, Earnhardt Jr. will be a ton faster than the race leaders. Marty?
Alan, the leaders are pitting together. Carl Edwards hits pit road. He said anything you can do to give me a little more grip would be appreciated. We're a little better than I thought we would be at the end of this run. An air pressure adjustment on the front end. You also saw the wedge adjustment on the right side, trying to loosen this car up at the end of the run. AB?
Kenseth, a 4-tire change and a pretty good stop by this crew. And Kenseth is off with an advantage over Carl Edwards. You see there.
Cliff Boyer, who's had a great run, 4 top fives in the last 6 races, making his way to his pit box, wants to go back up on the track bar, reverse the change they made at the previous stop, made the car way too tight. Solid stop going on. How about your end, AB?
Well, Kevin Harvick telling his crew what we've all seen on the racetrack. His car is good on the short run, but needs some help if this race comes down to a long green flag run. The speed falls off, and the front end loses grip the farther they go on a run. They're trying to adjust for that. Marty?
Paul Menard told his guys, you know, I wouldn't change much because at the end of the run, we are just so good. In fact, he said the car is, quote, perfect, not tight at all, and that loose condition they have early on the run goes away. It just takes so long to come in that they're going to put a half pound in the right front tire, trying to tighten up just a little bit at the beginning of that run. Dave?
Johnny Sauter is in. The guy in the odd-colored suit is Zach McGowan. That's because Joey Klutz, the rear tire carrier, is not here this weekend. His son Jonathan involved in an accident at home in North Carolina. So Zach taking over, carrying tires. Bit of a long stop for the double zero, fixing a tight race car, Marty.
Well, Dave, Denny Hamlin will make the slow walk down pit road here at Homestead. He hits pit road running second. They were able to stay out just a little bit longer, very fast in the middle part of that run. But at the end of the run, he said it gets tight from the center of the corner off really bad. They're going to do an air pressure and a wedge adjustment. Half pound out of both left side tires, second stop in a row. Actually, at the last minute, they decided to forego that wedge adjustment. Just the half pound out of both left side tires, trying to loosen that car up a little bit at the end of the run. And also a windshield tearaway. AB?
And giving J.J. Yaley instructions as he comes down pit road. He's got brake fans on the car. They've instructed him to turn those off so they're not blowing all the brake dust back in the face of the tire changers as they're trying to pull the tires off the car. His crew chief, Jason Ratcliffe, counting him into the pits. They're going to make a 4-tire change here for J.J. Yaley. Marty?
Alan, what a run for Todd Cleaver. He's kept his car up in the top 10 all day long, driven a very smart race to this point. He said he can't find the grip that he would like on the bottom of the racetrack, and it goes tight too early in the run. So what they're going to do, an air pressure adjustment, trying to make that sweet spot of the run a little bit longer.
Clint Bowyer's team up on the wall waiting for him to make a return visit to pit road. Officials saying Lewis Lux on the left front also going to make a chassis adjustment on that two car when he makes his way back to a stop. You can see the front tire changer hit the lug. They top it off of fuel. He's away. Costly mistake for Clint Bowyer's team.
Well, you just can't have that happen, can you, Matt?
Especially in the season finale when you're trying to possibly close in on another position in the championship standings.
Good point. Dave?
Regan Smith on pit road now. The last run, his car was loose going into the corner. This run, loose going into the corner. Same thing for Regan. They will make an air pressure adjustment for the driver of the 35 car. Crew on the right side now. They'll make their way around to the left side. No wrenches going in the windows. Just changing the air pressure will help Regan's car not be quite so loose in during the next run. Hopefully, Alan.
When Regan Smith pitted, that handed the lead over to this driver, Brian Vickers, in the Hendrick 57. Now, it's going to be a little while before Vickers pits. He came in under the fifth caution, the last one we had, at lap 71, and topped off his fuel. He gave up 12th position on the racetrack, restarted 24th, has picked his way back through traffic, and now has got some extra laps to run on fuel. If a caution comes out here while he's got some guys trapped a lap down, he's just helped himself a lot.
He's got about, if you think about 20 laps, A.B.?
Let's see, pit it at 71, so 70 and 60, that'd be 130, probably about a little less than 10 more laps, Bill.
Okay. So Brian Vickers back out front using strategy to get there. See how it plays out for him. 124 laps complete in the Ford 300. Next summer, Turner Sports will continue its 24-year run covering NASCAR with six Nextel Cup races starting June 10th in Pocono, including the primetime race from Daytona. So be sure you join us in the summer of 2007 for all the drama of NASCAR on TNT. And I know we're looking forward to that.
I'll be there.
It'll be a blast. Turner Sports, a longtime partner with NASCAR, and we'll be back with you next summer. Brian Vickers is the race leader. John Wood is second. Scott Wimmer runs third. As Alan talked about, the 57 pitted back on lap 71. Wood and Wimmer pitted on lap 68 under the same caution. Right now, there are just 14 cars on the lead lap, but Vickers is considerably slower than the guys that have stopped under green here.
Yeah, he's losing a lot of track time right now. That's what happens when you're on old tires. Everybody else is on good tires.
This is back around the 10th position. Harvick in the 21, Hamlin in the 20. Down the back stretch. Back up front, John Wood working on Vickers for the lead. Again, these guys out of sequence with the rest of the front runners. They pitted under a caution. Wood on lap 68. Vickers on lap 71, trying to use pit strategy. What they need right now is a caution flag to wave. If that caution doesn't come out, they're sunk.
Yeah, because they've lost a lot of track time. Right, it's a good gamble, because if the caution does come out, they've got three quarters of the field that's a lap or more down. Here, and it's going to be about three laps before the 57 of Vickers pits.
John Wood wants to take the lead away, and does. So Vickers slips to second. And John Wood assumes the race lead.
If this thing does stay green and this thing gets sorted out, Kenseth will wind up back at the point.
Matt Kenseth is not out front, but he's leading, is what you're
yeah.
saying. Runs in
He'll
the fourth
be there
spot.
Soon. Yep.
Kenseth is fourth. Then it's Edwards, Menard, Earnhardt Jr., Hamlin, Harvick, and Yaley. You can see Vickers' car just really giving up time on the track.
That's Daniel Quinn there in the 50 car, the blue car. He's sitting in the 27th spot, and he's passing second place car, so to speak.
Yes. Pressure tires are always nice.
Here they come.
So Wood and Vickers head for pit road. Keep an eye out for Wimmer as well. There's the speed limit line. Wood heads for his stall, and Vickers will head down pit road to the turn one side.
Take the right side tires on. They're obviously put four tires on. Fill it with fuel. And get out of Dodge. And of course, like we talked about, whoa! He almost took equipment and people with him.
Allen.
Well, all the way down pit road, Brian Vickers was talking to his crew. I don't know how many laps are left. I don't know what you got cooking here, but we're going to be a lap down after the pit stop as we see a lead change on the track. Matt Kenseth goes out in front. Vickers is pitting here with 64 laps to go. He might make it to the finish on fuel if he can be on the lead lap and this thing stays green for a while.
Yeah, a few minutes ago he was hoping for the caution. Now he hopes there are no more cautions.
That's it.
Could be some wacky strategy working out for Brian Vickers. So Kenseth.
So I think that Wood did take something out of his pits. See, the catch can there is still hooked to the back of the car. He tried grabbing it.
Did everything he could.
Yeah.
Didn't he? So that'll be a stop and go penalty for John Wood, removing equipment from the pit stall. So their strategy blows up on them. Matt Kenseth leads Scott Wimmer, Carl Edwards, Paul Menard, and Denny Hamlin. Closing in on about 60 to go here in Homestead. 142 laps are complete in the Ford 300 of the 2006 season finale for the NASCAR Busch Series. Matt Kenseth is the race leader. Then it's Carl Edwards, Paul Menard, Denny Hamlin, and Dale Earnhardt Jr., the top five. 11 cars are on the lead lap, but there could be trouble developing for the race leader. An update from Alan Best.
Well, Bill, just a couple laps ago, Matt Kenseth jumped on his radio to crew chief Jimmy Fennig, and he said, the engine has started skipping. I can't be 100% sure, but I'm 90% sure. Jimmy told him, switch to the backup ignition box. Matt did, radioed in that his voltages look good. And he said now, just now, he said, well, maybe I'm losing my mind. It seems okay now. I was watching the lap times, and his lap times hadn't fallen off any compared to second place Carl Edwards. So we'll see, but for now, maybe a false alarm there from the leader.
We'll keep an eye on that along with you. It is a 6.5 second lead for Kenseth over Carl Edwards. JJ Yaley, Todd Cleaver. Cleaver has the seventh spot. Yaley is eighth. And as Marty talked about, this is a good run for Todd Cleaver. Exactly what he needs to do. He needs to run in the top 10, and he needs to be on the track without customizing the car at the end of the race.
Right. And this is one of these, and this is one of the guys that he wants to finish the season with a great run.
Right.
And build some momentum going into next year with this team.
Appeared to be destined for the sixth car. That not happening. So Todd trying to showcase his talent in the NASCAR Busch Series. Looking to make a move under Kevin Harvick. So Todd Cleaver continues going forward. Everyone chasing Matt Kenseth at Homestead. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. NASCAR Busch Series Racing, the Ford 300 on TNT from the Homestead Miami Speedway, is brought to you by Propane. Propane, exceptional energy. By FreeCreditReport.com. Log on to FreeCreditReport.com and get the score. And by the Principal Financial Group. We'll give you an edge. 151 laps complete. 48 now to go. Matt Kenseth, the race leader, by 6 seconds over Carl Edwards. Then Paul Menard, Denny Hamlin, Dale Earnhardt Jr. There are now just 9 cars on the lead lap. Cleaver, Yaley, Harvick, and Casey Kane.
Man, that at
the top 9.
That's a brutal pace. I mean, 9 cars
right
on the lead lap, and it's not over yet.
next car that Kenseth catches would be Casey Kane. This has been a strong run for Matt. Harvick led 64 laps. Matt has just led his 65th lap of the race. Ryan Vickers led 11 laps, and a handful of drivers have led a lap or two. And as Wally's talked about, the longer this 17 car goes under green, the better it seems to get. And that's what they've been working on. And you just wonder if Matt Kenseth and Robbie Reiser can make a run like this tonight pay off tomorrow. Alan?
Well, Bill, no more on the engine miss on Matt Kenseth. His last update talked about maybe I'm losing my mind, but I think everything's fine now. His lap times are certainly reflecting that. So now we look ahead as to what's up with this race team toward the finish. One more pit stop, maybe around somewhere close to lap 180 if this thing stays green. And then it could get really interesting because there's some guys that can go to the finish on fuel if it stays green. Mike?
Alan, his teammate Carl Edwards is about two-tenths of a second faster almost every lap. Of course, that lap is a little bit slower, but he has a five-second deficit. That's the problem. The 60 car finally has the car where they want it, a little bit loose into the corner, very good through the middle, a little loose on exit, but Carl is so far behind the 17 because of the pace you guys talked about. They made up some ground on that green flag pit stop, the 17 did. He actually expanded the ground they had on the 60, but Carl has a long way to go, but a car that might be able to pass him if they could finally get up there. Bill, I think it's very vital to note Carl Edwards has cut 14 points off Kevin Harvick's championship lead today. That's very important information. That big 14 points might help out.
And that narrows it to 816 points.
He's closing in.
Paul Menard's another one that's very, very fast right now.
Runs in the third spot in the Ford 300. 161 laps are complete in the Ford 300. Here's our Holiday Inn race recap. Wally had some friends here at the track. There's Kevin and Delana Harvick, and Kevin picks up that trophy after this race tonight as the 2006 champion. Number of incidents early in the race. Reed Sorensen.
Up in flames of smoke. Fills the car with smoke, but Reed gets out. He's okay.
Then a lot of guys, little racing room, multi-car wreck. Stephen Wallace,
Leffler, Hornaday.
And this is Kyle Busch and Shane Huffman after David Rudiman took some of the air off the five car. Our Holiday Inn race recap. Well done, guys. Matt Kenseth out front. 163 laps now complete. 37 to go. He leads by 7 seconds over Carl Edwards.
And the next guy he's going to lap if he gets to him is... Well, there's Yaley and then Harvick.
Right. There's Todd Cleaver. And Dale Earnhardt Jr. Cleaver just took the fifth spot from Earnhardt. Marty?
Yeah, Bill's going to clarify that. That's him moving around Dale Earnhardt Jr. for the fifth position. What a terrific run for this young man today, the 28-year-old out of Wisconsin. You know, I talked to him earlier. He said, I really hate that the season is going to end because things are finally just gelling. As you mentioned, he was up for the sixth car earlier this year, the Nextel Cup Series ride, filling in for Mark Martin. That never happened, and next year, he'll be just a part-time driver in the Busch Series, sharing a ride with Greg Biffle in just 16 races. He told me, you know, the season has finally come together, finally where I want it, and it ends. And I just want to take this momentum into next year, but I won't have a full-time ride, but I want to show what I can do in this final race, and he's certainly doing it right now in fifth. Alan?
And just an update on Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s progress after his stop. He said, good stop, good adjustments to his crew. And hasn't said a whole lot yet. His car seems to have the same drivability as it did before. Right there in the center of the corner, he just can't get it to cut the way he needs it to. And Wally, you know, that keeps you from getting on the gas.
Yeah, that's unfortunately when you have a car like that, you got to roll out the throttle, and you just have to wait until the front sticks before you can get back on the gas. And sometimes that takes forever.
There are just 8 cars on the lead lap. As Wally pointed out, running 8th, Kevin Harvick. Matt Kenseth is the race leader. Caution has just come out. Caution for debris on the front stretch.
Front stretch, don't see it.
Hey man,
need to be a little tighter for the show to run here. I see there's 33 to go, 32 to go.
That's exactly right, 33 to go, Matt.
Yeah, I can't catch up, guys. It takes me 30 laps because I'm too loose, so.
And these guys were only maybe 13 to 15 laps away from having to make a pit stop.
And as you heard Matt say, they need to work on the short run. His car's not been very good on the restarts, and it takes some laps, so they need to make an adjustment so that thing won't go for the last 30 laps.
Casey Kane is the lucky dog. Gets to come around, get back on the lead lap. Car 9 will be the ninth car on the lead lap. So just 9 cars coming down pit road, and it will be open when they get there. Behind the safety vehicle, they work down the backstretch. It's Kenseth, Edwards, Menard, Hamlin, and Todd Cleaver, the top 5. Then it's Earnhardt Jr., Yaley, Harvick, and Kane, your top 9 cars, the only cars on the lead lap. They peel off on the backstretch. And head for pit road. It's going to be a short run to the finish here. Kenseth has been better on the longer runs. As Wally talked about, they'll try and adjust for that when he reaches his pit stall. On to pit road they come. Marty.
Well, Carl Edwards, this is exactly what he needed. He'll be in the middle of your screen in that 60 car. He hits pit road running second. They think they're as good as a 17. All they needed was that ground made up. The caution did that. He said he likes the car right now, but it stayed free for that entire run, half a round in the left rear of Wedge. That's the only change they're going to make. On the bottom of your screen, Paul Menard, who was terrific at the end of that run, by far the best car. Once again, the car was a little too loose at the beginning of the run, a pound once again in that right front tire. Alan?
Trouble on the right front for Matt Kenseth's team. He might lose the lead on this stop. You see cars in the right-hand picture already coming down the pit lane. Carl Edwards is going to be by. Looks like Paul Menard's going to be by. That was not a good time to have a trouble-filled stop.
Yeah, Denny Hamlin also, I think, got by him.
He's going to lose the race for us. We'll do everything we can, but we're just
fine. You heard Matt. Very disappointed. The race off of pit road. Kenseth gives up the lead in the pits. NASCAR Busch Series Racing, the Ford 300 from Homestead, brought to you by the Ford Shelby GT500. Bold moves, they happen every day. By Miller Lite, for great taste, there's no debate. Miller Lite, always a good call. And by Sirius Satellite Radio, the best radio on radio. Field has gotten the one-to-go signal. Carl Edwards was 7 seconds behind the race leader. He now is the race leader, and here's what happened to the 17 car of Matt Kenseth on pit road.
If you watch the right front tire changer, he's hitting the lugs. I think he thinks he got all the lugs off. Puts the gun down, then he sees, oh, I got to hit another lug. That cost him the lead. Just that 1 second when he had to go back and hit it.
Jimmy Fennig is crew chief. And you could even see him, he'd already reversed the gun.
Yeah, that's right.
He had to switch it back.
Exactly. When he picked the gun up, he hit a button. That was because that was ready to tighten at that point. AB?
And Matt came on the radio when he was leaving pit road, and Bill and Wally, you know Matt is usually a fairly frank guy. He came on and said, well, that probably just lost us the race. He said, our car just takes too long to come in. I'm not sure I can get all the way back to the front from there. He's back to fourth. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, and to make things worse, you got all these cars on the bottom, too.
Just 9 cars on the lead lap. Edwards leads. You want to make a point about Menard.
I think Menard's car is as good as anybody's in this race, but again, it takes 15 laps to get going. By the time 15, 20 laps comes around, he's already 4 or 5 seconds behind the leader. So if they've made an adjustment to that car to help it get going better, he's got one of the better cars in this race.
29 laps to go. Edwards clears the lap traffic. Menard's still working on it. Menard got by, but Denny Hamlin is bottled up back there. And here comes Kenseth with Harvick right on his bumper.
Yeah, he got Kenseth a little bit loose there in 4. Now these guys are looking at cars in front of them side by side. That's going to let the leaders get away.
Hamlin has cleared the lap car. Now Kenseth is by. Regan Smith in that 35. Harvick is by, and Earnhardt trying to tag along.
Denny Hamlin's looking pretty good right there. The bottom of Paul Menard right now.
And again, it just doesn't look like Menard's car is that good on the get-go.
Yeah, he needed this thing to go long green. And I don't think there's enough laps in it for him to take advantage of it unless they made the right adjustments.
Marty?
Well, guys, when Denny Hamlin came to pit road, he had a race car that was a little bit tight. They made a very slight air pressure adjustment. When they took the wheels off, they found out the left front tire was going down. Hamlin is also fourth in the championship standings, so he desperately wants to pass Paul Menard and finish in front of him, because right now he could possibly get to third if he finishes in the second position, third position tonight. Alan?
I haven't talked about Kevin Harvick in turn two.
Smith. Regan Smith. Caution number 7.
I'm too loose, man. In this team.
No lucky dog, because it would have been Regan Smith. Instead, he's the unlucky dog. Wanted the caution to come out, just didn't want to be it. Dave, you know something about this?
They had just commented to Regan, hey, now we'll see just how lucky we are, because they were racing for the lucky dog position, had taken on two right side tires only on that last stop, but were racing really hard with Johnny Sauter to stay ahead of him and hopefully see another caution and get that free pass, but they can't, as you explained.
It was a plan.
Yeah, he was way, way up high. In the marbles. Is that Bickers that he tapped?
Wow. Yes, in the 57. On board Juan Pablo Montoya.
Man of the square tape.
Hey, Tubbs, you look like you put on some holiday LBs, buddy.
Field coming to get the green. Hope you're with us Friday, December 1st at 9 p.m. on TNT for the 2006 Nextel Cup Series Awards Ceremony. Special guests are Jay Moore, the musical guest Jewel from the Waldorf Astoria in New York City. Honor the champion and the top 10 drivers in the championship standings. Friday, December 1st, 9 o'clock, right here on TNT. Field.
You working that gig?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Looking forward to it. Edwards is the race leader. 22 to go when they get the green. Boy, Menard right on his bumper.
Yeah, that's good.
NASCAR did look at the running order when Regan Smith spun. Johnny Sauter had made the pass for the position, so Johnny Sauter did get a lucky dog under that caution. He is the 10th car running on the lead lap.
I think Sauter started like 39th. Today, so he has done a really nice job.
Here comes Matt. Ends it into second. And now sets his focus on Carl Edwards.
A little bit loose up there, Kenseth is. Looks like he's pretty fast right now. I don't know.
And on a mission.
I don't know if Carl's going to be able to hold him off or not. He's just running that line. It's just been working for him. So nice tonight.
He did say he tried to make it up on the track when he left pit road. Gave up the lead on pit road when his front tire changer missed a lug nut on the right front tire.
Carl's car is pretty good in one and two. Maybe even a little bit better than Matt. But Matt really gets into turn three. Very good.
And Carl knows how good that 17 car has been tonight. So he's looking in the mirror every now and then, huh?
And that's not helping.
Menard runs third, then Hamlin, then Harvick.
Now, Harvick should be really pretty good here.
called a short run.
Harvick in that 21 car. Harvick runs in fifth, Allen.
Yeah, you know, when they had that caution come out and got the restart with 29 to go, Kevin talked about if we can have a couple of 10 or 12 lap runs, I think I can do something. I think I can get to the front. Well, they only had a few laps of racing before that last caution flag came out. Well, we'll see, but right now he's not able to do anything with Denny Hamlin. He was with him, then he drifted back, and he's trying to catch back up. And just car's just not there for Kevin tonight like we've seen it most of this year.
9 wins this season for Harvick. 10 would tie the series record. This is the last race of the season for the NASCAR Busch Series. Harvick clinched the championship 6 months ago, wasn't it?
Yeah. I think when we started back in July.
The trophy presentation tonight. He'd like to make it in victory lane. He's got his work cut out for him. Edwards, strong since the restart.
The clean air helps just a little bit.
And as we've talked about through the race, Kenseth's car has gotten better the longer they go. The question is this run going to be long enough for him to improve?
Kenseth's car looks like it's a little bit loose to me still. Car's still twitching a little bit.
Bernard the fastest that time at the line. Sorry, Wally.
I'm just saying that I think Bernard sees that, and he's trying to get up on Kansas bumper just to loosen him up a little bit so he can take that spot and try to run Edwards down.
That's not very nice.
It isn't, but it's effective.
We're all chasing Carl, Marty.
And Carl's trying to pull away from everybody. Remember that piece of video we showed earlier from Michigan where Carl Edwards got spun by Dale Earnhardt Jr.?
Yes.
Well, this is that race car, Bill. And he said, this car deserves to win. It should have won there at Michigan had it not been for that little melee we had with Jr. He told me that before the race. Just radioed to his crew, the car is a little loose out front. But as advertised, he said, if I could get past the 17, I think we can stay out in front of him. So far, he's able to do it.
Carl's had a few of those moments this year, hasn't he, Marty?
He's had a couple, Bill, and he wants to kind of rid himself of that and get back to victory lane. You know, it's been a long time. It's been since St. Louis in July since that 60 car went to victory lane.
And Carl has not won in the Nextel Cup Series this season.
J.J. Yealey just takes a spot away from Earnhardt. That's for 6th.
See, Harvick has fallen back off the bumper of the 20. And there's Yealey, and there's Junior. Like Matt's starting to close in a little. Knock 3/10 off that lap.
Wow.
That's awesome.
But catching and passing,
okay.
Two different things.
Got 12 and a half laps to work on him.
Well, let's see now. Matt's going to try it down on the bottom, see what he's got down there. I thought maybe it'd be tough for Matt because he's got to run that high line. That's where he's been really, really strong. I think he went down there to give it a shot. Ooh, I don't know if I would have done that. I don't know if I leave Matt that high groove right now.
I don't think I would either. They might have just told him that on the radio. Edwards going to try and block, but Matt's already there. Kenseth for the lead.
Edwards has got to stay on the high side. He doesn't want 17 car to come across his nose, so that's going to be it. The race will be over. So he's got to fight hard on that high side.
Boy, nice job. Held him off. 11 to go. Bernard watches for third.
Single file.
Except for that guy in the left for the quarter panel.
Here comes Matt again. Down the backstretch, headed for 3.
Carl's got to stay there, and he gave it, you know, I mean, he didn't give it to him, but yeah, he saw Matt coming. That's all Matt needed, and I think it's bye-bye time now.
Carl's banging the steering wheel right now. Shouldn't have lifted. Carl coming back on the 17. And Menard and Hamlin want to join this battle. 10 to go. Menard just waiting and waiting for that car to hook up.
See what, the 11, it is hooked up right there. I mean, he's just getting a good run.
Nine to go, Marty.
I was going to say, guys, the one they all better watch out for is Paul Menard. Very good at the end of the run all night long. Wally, he's been making hay on that top line. This is a team that has not finished in the top 10 in the last four races. When he was strapping in, Paul told me this race is very important because that is not indicative of how this team has run this year. We deserve a top 10 tonight, and I want to show this is a race team that can contend for a championship.
Be careful they don't throw that caution for all that hay out there in that top line.
I knew something was coming.
Kenseth leads.
He has been. I mean, you know, he has been very good. I think now he's kind of at a spot now where, you know, you're in this traffic here, and you're getting in that air off those first two cars. And it just takes a little bit of that handling away from your car when you're in that situation. Look at Edwards pulling up, man. He's not giving up.
Menard finished fifth here last year. Runs in third behind Edwards and Kenseth. Seven to go. Shaley in the 18 and Harvick in the 21. That's for fifth. Behind this battle. Top four cars right here. Matt searching a little bit there or just trying to throw Edwards off?
Yeah, I think he's just messing around now. He's got seven to go, and any little thing you can try to break the concentration of the guy behind you who's chasing, you'll do.
Hamlin right on the bumper. Six to go. Again, Edwards looks slow in one and two.
He gets right there, and car tightens up. He gets in really good. He gets to the center. Then he jumps on the gas, the car just tightens up, and he can't cut. He can't stay underneath the lead car of Matt Kenseth.
Hamlin continues to work on Menard for third. Allen.
Bill, sometimes a pit crew picks up a driver. They gain him that spot he needs to win the race on pit road. Sometimes a driver has to pick up a pit crew. Matt Kenseth is doing that right now. That's why they call it a team. Everybody has to get it right in order to win the race. Sometimes you got to help a teammate out to take that checkered flag, huh?
You bet. Matt went to victory lane in the Busch race at Phoenix last week. Kenseth starts 19th tomorrow. Jimmy Johnson starts 15th. Kenseth 63 points behind in the chase for the Nextel Cup Championship. He's out front here and trying to pull away from Edwards.
See, Hamlin is trying to work that bottom. And he makes some ground up on Paul Menard.
Now Menard, ready to go to work on Edwards. Three to go now.
Left, three.
Kenseth trying to edge away.
I think he's doing a pretty good job, really. I'm edging away.
Yes. And Edwards has his hands full now trying to save his position instead of challenge for Matt.
Yeah, these three cars right here are so evenly matched. And like I said, it looks like all of them are a little bit tight. So it's going to be real difficult to make a pass unless somebody does it on the high side. And I think they all know that. You see, Denny's down on the bottom. I think he just can't get the car to stick, but he got some bite on that one.
Gonna try now. Down the back stretch inside of two to go. This is for third. Kenseth leads him off of four. White flag, last lap. Kenseth, then Edwards. Hamlin and Menard for third. Denny really trying to get it done. Matt's gonna run into some lap traffic here on the final lap. Down the back.
Oh, we got somebody spinning off four.
Caution is out. Caution is out.
Caution. Front straight here.
Jay Sauter, the 01 car.
Bring her home.
That will be the checkered.
Yes, it will. Checkered flag is out.
Good job. Thanks, man. You got.
And Matt Kenseth has won at Homestead. After the leaders have taken the white, when the caution comes out, the race is over. NASCAR will use their scoring loops and video tape to determine the final finishing positions. But Matt Kenseth is the race winner. And it'll be interesting to see who finished third. Menard and Hamlin.
I think Menard had
I think he did
spot.
Too.
Yeah, I think Hamlin fell in behind Paul on that last lap.
Congratulatory tap from Dale Earnhardt Jr. So Matt Kenseth came on the pit road. His front tire changer had an issue. They gave up the top spot. Matt got it back. He's headed to victory lane. We're headed to Allen.
Jimmy Fenwick, the winning crew chief, two in a row, Jimmy. Sometimes a driver has to pick up a team. Sometimes the team has to pick up the driver. You kind of had to have a little bit of that tonight.
Yeah, I'll tell you one thing. Matt picked up this team. We've been putting them behind every week on pit road, you know, a little bit. We've been struggling, but Matt, I'll tell you one thing, drove the wheels off that car. Matt's an awesome race car driver.
On the other side, Matt came on the radio after the checkers and thanked you and the team for preparing such a great race car for him. Thoughts?
Well, you know, we keep everybody works hard at the shop back in Concord and Mooresville, and that's the key of winning is just how hard you work at things. And everybody's been doing a good job. None's been falling off the car, and I still got to give the guys credit.
Credit to you too. Congratulations. Two straight wins. Jimmy Fenwick.
I love when they do burnouts and they actually leave a fire on the racetrack.
There you go.
That is a burnout.
That's very nice. Third win of 2006. 21st career win for Matt Kenseth. His first at Homestead. We're going to victory lane when we come back. Ford 300 has just ended at the Homestead Miami Speedway in South Florida. Matt Kenseth, the race winner. He's in victory lane, and so is Marty Snyder.
And Mr. Kenseth ends the 2006 Busch Series season in style, the 25th anniversary for the Busch Series, with a second straight win and win number three of 2006. I thought the shower was coming there, Matt. Let's talk about that last pit stop. Do you think the race was over at that point?
Well, yeah, just because, you know, we're set up so good for a long run, and we weren't too good for 20 laps or so. Them guys could all outrun me. So I thought we were in trouble, but Jimmy made some good adjustments with the fuel and some other things to get it tight enough for a short run.
You and your buddy Carl Edwards started the race off by taking some shots at each other, calling himself the best driver out here, and you had a terrific battle there at the end. Were you worried at all? Because he was trying to take away your line for a while.
Yeah, I mean, Carl's a great driver, and I really enjoyed racing with him a lot. We were just giving each other a hard time before the race, but he gave me a little extra room. I kind of slid up in front of him there a little bit, but we were wasting a lot of time, and I seen 11 was coming, and I had to get it done pretty soon. So sure was a pleasure to drive these cars. It's all about Ford Championship weekend. Proud to be driving a Ford Fusion, and thanks to Pennzoil and everybody for their help.
And it is all about the championship for you, the Nextel Cup Championship possibly tomorrow. How will tonight help you tomorrow?
Oh, man, I learned some stuff. Jimmy's in big trouble. No, I don't know.
You get a lot of ground there.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's a lot of fun to run. You know, you learn a little bit about the racetrack and the lines and what the tires are going to do and setups and that type of thing. So I kind of know what our car needs to feel like to be good in the long run. So it was a lot of fun.
I think the most impressive part about the win was the burnout. Do you know you let flames out on the racetrack?
Every once in a while, you got to go nuts. So I didn't do one last week, and I figured I'd get a hard time about it. But I usually don't tear it up too bad on Saturdays. I'm a little more old school, like Jeff Burton and Mark Martin don't like to tear up stuff. But that was a pretty exciting race. That was pretty fun.
The impressive part was he told his guys, I'm going to light it up here for a second. He certainly did that. A 10 for the burnout and a 10 for the win on Matt Kenseth today. Dave?
And Marty, with the guy who wished he was doing the burnouts here, Carl Edwards, trying to catch Matt there at the end. Tell us what was going on behind the wheel.
That was fun, man. I don't know what to say. I mean, Matt's a great teammate. I have a great sponsor in AmeriQuest and have a great team. We had a lot of fun, man. That's all I could do at the end. I mean, that's fun. That's a good race, and I'm glad Matt won it. The only thing that'd be better is if he's over there celebrating that Nextel Cup championship tomorrow.
Well, he called you a great driver, by the way, the ongoing thing back and forth here. At what point did you say to yourself, okay, I got to worry about the 11 behind me because he was coming?
Right after Matt started pulling away, I started noticing that Paul was getting closer, and my good buddy Denny went up and raced him and slowed him down enough that that we got out there and ended up second. But I just got to thank all the fans and everybody for supporting our team this year, and congratulations to Kevin Harvick for his championship, and Man, it's just it's fun. It's fun. I'm going to go watch a meteor shower now.
A lot of positives for Carl Edwards in the Busch Series this year. To Matt Yoakum.
And Denny Hamlin unofficially finishes the season fourth in the championship standings. You just looked at the points. 16 points is what you needed to jump into the third spot. You would have needed to pass a few more cars tonight, but a good run.
Yeah, it looks like we would need to win a race. And you know, we had a car that could do it there at the end. We just, you know, track position would have meant so much. And once Matt got around Carl, you know, he really didn't pull away from us. So it was fun battling those three at the end. That was the most fun I've had in a long time in the Busch Series. And I'm looking forward to next year when I can run just for wins and not have to worry about points.
Looking ahead to tomorrow, did you learn anything tonight you can carry over to the Cup program, trying to close in on possibly winning that next Cup championship?
Well, I know we got a great race car for tomorrow. I mean, in my opinion, we have one of the best cars in happy hour. And I think we're going to be back there in traffic for a while, but I think eventually our car is going to come to the front.
Great run tonight for Denny Hamlin.
Thanks, Matt. Well, this year, Kevin Harvick smoked the competition in the points. And now he is celebrating the 2006 NASCAR Busch Series Championship. The huge burnout on the front stretch. And now he heads for the stage that's been set up along the track.
And they set that thing up fast.
Yeah, they did.
I mean, look, it all sets up.
And the presentation in front of the fans here at Homestead. Unofficially, Harvick sixth in tonight's race. 9 wins this season. His second Busch Series championship. Starts 7th tomorrow and still in the hunt for that Nextel Cup championship. Great season for Harvick in the Busch Series. Now he will climb out and celebrate the championship with his team and the fans here at Homestead. He climbs out. Here's Allen.
With the champion, Kevin Harvick. When you have a shower in South Florida, sometimes it rains pretty heavily. Congratulations. What a season. Are there words to describe from you what this year's been like in this car?
Not really. I mean, it's been absolutely amazing to be a part of. And, you know, tonight we felt like we were off a little bit and ran six. So this whole U.S. Coast Guard team, everybody on the Dollar General and the Outdoor Channel Chevrolets, they've all just worked together and gave me good cars every time I've been on the racetrack. So to win 9 races, I know we came up a little bit short of Sam Hard, but to win 9 races and run like we have this year is something that I know I'll probably never get to be a part of again in the Busch Series, and hopefully someday we can do this in the Cup Series. But it's been an incredible year, and got to thank everybody involved, Richard Takato, Snap-on, all the people that support us. So it's been a great year.
How difficult has it been at times, shuffling back and forth, running both races, jumping on a jet from one place to the other? How difficult has it been from the driver's point of view?
Well, to be honest with you, Will Lynn and everybody's done a great job really organizing everything and making sure the travel's done right. And everybody has been through this once before. So to do it all again is something that they acted like it was easy. And I'll be honest with you, it was so organized that it seemed easy. So. We've been through it once, and you know, the whole reason we did this year, I just didn't really know where I was going to go with the Cup stuff, and this is such a good place to kind of get away from everything and really just get in a car and race. So everybody asked why. That's why we did it, because I really didn't know, and Richard didn't know how the performance was going to be. We'd changed a lot of things and knew that my contract was up, and we got through all that mess, but that's the real reason why we did this.
People who win multiple championships oftentimes get asked the differences between the two. Your first Busch Series championship was as a series regular back in 2001. Now you've been a Nextel Cup regular for some time. Different feeling with this championship than the first one?
Yeah, I mean, they're different. Obviously, 2001 was a year that it was very different for all of us at RCR with Dale's passing and everything that happened there on the Cup side. It's like we didn't really have time to enjoy it. We've enjoyed every minute of everything we've done this year. We've been on the top, we've been on the bottom of things, and you know, when you come back to the top the second time, you really learn to respect things a lot more and you know, appreciate everything that we've been able to do this year. So I think the second time around it seems like it's a lot more. We're a lot more aware of how hard it is to get here and how hard things are to come by in this sport.
Going to let you spend a few minutes with your team, and then they've got a trophy they want to give you. Kevin Harvick. Back down here for a trophy presentation shortly, Bill.
Thanks, Alan. 32 top tens and 35 races for Kevin Harvick. Back with more in a moment. TNT Sports is live at the Homestead Miami Speedway in South Florida, where the 2006 NASCAR Busch Series has just come to its conclusion. Matt Kenseth won the race. Kevin Harvick is celebrating his series championship. Harvick now heading up on the stage to join his teammates and Richard Childress. There you see the scene, and down there in the middle of it is Alan Bestwick.
Yes, sir, Bill, waiting for the champion to make his way into the center of the crowd on stage. You see all of his Richard Childress Racing Team members are gathered around us here and waiting to be part of the celebration. Kevin taking a minute to share some time with them. Come on over here, champ. Ah, they're fitting him with some new outerwear as well. The latest in championship wear. All right, let's get the formal ceremony going. Let me introduce the president of NASCAR, Mr. Mike Helton. Mike.
Thank you, Alan. Kevin, congratulations on your second Busch Championship. You were excellent in the performance, and you were a great champion with us before, and I know you will. Richard, Judy, congratulations to the entire 21 of Richard Childress Racing. We'll celebrate with you in Orlando in about 3 weeks.
Well, the Series Awards Banquet coming up in Orlando in a couple of weeks. And now to present the championship trophy, Jim Lukowski from Anheuser-Busch. Jim, congratulations on another great season.
Well, I'll tell you, Kevin, 9 Busch Series victories this year. I think it was 23 top fives. Busch Series championship. Congratulations, team owner Richard Childress, crew chief Shane Wilson, and the entire number 21 Chevrolet Coast Guard team. Bet you it feels pretty good, huh?
It feels great. Thank
congratulations.
You. Appreciate everything you guys do.
I believe that is yours now, sir.
Sounds good. I get to actually keep it. This time, I get to keep it.
Kevin Harvick, the champion. RC, let me get a word with the champion owner. Pardon me, I'm going to reach right across. You stay in the picture, too, if you would, please. RC, congratulations on another championship for Richard Childress Racing.
Thank you. It was a phenomenal year. The performance that Kevin did and all the guys is just unbelievable. I'm just glad to be part of it. And I'd like to thank the Coast Guard for sponsoring us this year and everyone else on the car. You know, it's just been a phenomenal year.
He's getting locked and loaded here, so I think things are going to get going with the celebration. Richard Childress Racing, winners of the NASCAR Busch Series Championship 2006, and the party's on.
Look out, Alan. I'll tell you what, they earned it. Just a spectacular year. Unofficially, he beat Carl Edwards by 824 points. And that could change once we get the official results from tonight's 4-300. We can take a look at the unofficial results after the caution came out on the final lap.
See, Paul Menard did finish in third spot. Kenny Hamlin in fourth. Casey Kane back up to eighth after being a lap down, got the lucky dog.
Johnny
Good
Sutter.
Job for Cleaver,
yeah.
Too.
And yeah, Todd Cleaver, very strong performance tonight. Juan Pablo Montoya, 14th, makes his Nextel Cup debut tomorrow. And as you look at the rest of the starting, the finishing order rather, again, it's unofficial. Had the pleasure of covering the Busch Series since late in the season in 1990. It has been a blast. And just our thanks to the drivers, the crews, and their families in that Busch garage. They're outstanding people. They've always treated us with patience and professionalism. We wish them the best. Kevin Harvick celebrates the 2006 NASCAR Busch Series Championship. Tomorrow, a champion will be crowned again. The Ford 400 on NBC. Coverage begins at 2 Eastern with the Bank of America countdown to green. Don't miss the countdown. Coming up next in the East, it's Tombstone. And in the West, The Rock in Walking Tall. That's next on TNT. Don't forget, tomorrow, the Ford 400 on NBC. Coverage begins at 2 o'clock Eastern time. We'll see you tomorrow on NBC, and we'll see you right back here next summer on TNT, when we have six of the hottest races of the summer from the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series. Kevin Harvick celebrates the championship. Matt Kenseth won the race. We'll see you tomorrow at 2 on NBC, and you'll meet the next NASCAR champion.